Hello, everyone. My name is Stefan Chandler Garcia, a developer advocate here at Salesforce. Now, this video today is a first in a series of Lightning Web Component fundamentals that we're going to use to help give you a better understanding of Lightning Web Component development, as well as maybe teach you a few tips and tricks that you didn't know about LWCs. Now, we're going to start out today by looking at JavaScript decorators. But before we get into how they work within Salesforce, let's take a look at them under the hood. JavaScript decorators have been around for a few years now, however, are still considered experimental. Generally speaking, a decorator is really a function that you can wrap around a class or a class element or other forms during the definition of that component. The official proposal for decorators outlines that decorators can be used to replace a value that's been wrapped by the decorator, to associate metadata with a value that's been wrapped, or to provide access to that value that's been decorated. In a moment, I'll break down how these relate to Lightning Web Components, but before that, it's worth noting that decorators aren't really something that you will be writing yourself in a component or in an app. They're more frequently used to simplify a framework like LWC or Angular by providing decorators for you to use. So JavaScript decorators are instantiated by annotating the at symbol and then passing in a value. You'll recognize this right away if you're familiar with writing Lightning Web Components. But it's worth noting that you can also add a decorator to a method, which can be incredibly useful. In order to get a better understanding of decorators, let's take a look at how we write one from scratch. So I want to create a decorator that will transform the text that I pass into it into all caps. I'm going to call it the shout decorator and create a property like I'm shouting at someone. I'm going to create a function that just takes in the value and returns a function that transforms it to uppercase. The easy part is that all we really have to do is then add the decorator to our property and pass in the value that we want to transform. Now, you could also ask me why this wouldn't just be a function, and that would be a great question to ask. If I was writing this in a component, I would just write a function, which is why in a lot of instances writing your own decorators are overkill. So I'd suggest leaving them to the frameworks to write for you so that you can just take advantage of the ease of that functionality. So now that we know more about how decorators work behind the scenes, let's take a look at how they work in Lightning Web Components. In this video, we're going to take a look at the API decorator, and as we continue through the series, we will look at the rest of them. So, the API decorator allows you to expose a property or a method as public. When writing LWCs, it's definitely the most common decorator that I use in my development, and I'm sure you will as well. When we think back to the definition of what a decorator is meant to do, this really covers the ability to provide access to something outside of the component. So let's go ahead and jump into VS Code and see how we can take advantage of this decorator. So I've created two Lightning Web Components to get us started, the decorator parent component and the decorator child component. We're going to be starting out in the decoratorchild.js file. The first thing that we need to do when using the decorator is modify the component's imports to include API from LWC. This will give us access to that decorator to use. This is taking the API function that's part of the LWC framework and exposing it through the API decorator, just like when we were writing our shout function and decorating the property using @shout. One of the most used functionalities of the API decorator is the ability to automatically populate a property with the record ID of the current record page, if the component is on a record page. This is something that would be built into the API function behind the scenes. All that you have to do is ensure that you've written the property correctly, with the correct capitalization, with a lowercase r and uppercase I, and add the decorator, @API record ID. In the component's HTML file, I've gone ahead and added some markup that will display the value of the record ID property whenever the component loads. Then, to expose the components, we just need to add in our target pages in the meta.js file of the component to make them available. So I've gone ahead and added the component to two pages, an account record page and a home page. So let's pop into the org and see how they respond. First, let's view an account record. And here we can see that our component has populated the record ID that was taken from the page's context. Now, let's go over to the home page. And here you can see that the property is empty, as there is no ID assigned to the page. That means that the decorator is checking the page type before it tries to replace the value of the record ID property. Now, let's take a look at another use case for the API decorator, exposing properties to the Lightning App Builder. The first thing we need to do is add another property to our component, and we'll call this one message, and we're going to add the decorator. Now, let's go ahead and go into our HTML and update it to include the message. Here you can see we're just going to display it in the same way we're displaying the record ID. And then lastly, we need to update our meta.js file to expose the property. We just need to add in our target config and then specify which page targets we would like the property to be available to. Then we can add the property and assign it by its name. We can enrich it by adding a label, set the type, and then a description. This is what will be exposing the property to the Lightning App Builder. Now that this has been updated, let's go ahead and take a look inside the Lightning App Builder. We can go ahead and edit the account's Lightning page, and this will open up the builder for us. You can then select the component and now view its properties. Here you can see that our message field has appeared and brought over that label and description that we set. So let's go ahead and put something into the field. And you can see that it's already responding in the UI, but let's go ahead and save the page and go back to our account. Here you can see that the message has been populated. So now let's go over to the home page. You will see here that there is no message. This is because the property is provided by the page that it sits on. That way you can provide different values to different page types. So now that you know a bit more about decorators, and in this case the API decorator in Salesforce, you can go ahead and take this to start building your own Lightning web components and really understand what's happening as that component is being compiled. So keep your eyes peeled for our next video, where we're going to be taking API decorators to the next level and communicating between parent and child components, exposing properties, and looking at how we can call methods on our child components through that decorator. If you have any questions, please feel free to put your comments down below in the comment box or reach out to me directly on Twitter at StephanWCG. And like always, you can always contact me at Stephan.Garcia@Salesforce.com. Thank you for watching this video on JavaScript decorators. Please be sure to like this video, subscribe to the Salesforce Developers YouTube channel, and click on the bell icon so that you can get notified each time that we post a new video.